I almost died once, and then it causes you to have these moments of like, what do you want to accomplish with your life? It took me a while, it took me a couple of years, but I want to be able to have a material impact on the world. Innovation is what materially improves lives. And so taking that to the next step, what causes innovation? When you look at human history and the invention of the light bulb or the invention of the steam engine, did one cheat off the other? Like, we didn't have the internet, and those were invented within like a month of each other. It's because the powerful tools that ended up being distributed worldwide are what enabled that innovation to occur.
Just as maybe about 100 years ago, electricity transformed industry after industry, everything from transportation, communications, manufacturing, healthcare was transformed with the rise of electricity. I think that today we see a surprisingly clear path for AI to transform all of these industries.
You know, if you take seriously the idea that AI is the new electricity, think of how many electrical engineers and how many electricians our society had to hire to take advantage of the capabilities.
So Luxonis is all about robotic perception. Our aim is to make that easy, and we do that across a variety of industries. Just like you'll see in animals, there are all sorts of different eyes, shapes, sizes, fields of view, spectral response. The same thing's true in robotics. We have a whole open source ecosystem from firmware all the way to cloud management that allows you to quickly embed perception into your robot based on your needs.
The kinds of problems that computer vision will be applied to, that's just huge. It's like, you know, we have given eyes to the computers.
Open sourcing our designs allows the customer to take our framework and then build upon that if necessary, or just takes it as it is. What once was a very labor-intensive process to get even the most basic computer vision up and running is now very much a breeze.
We see so many opportunities and so many cases that can be solved with this new product. So one side is hardware we can offer, so you don't have to develop your own. But the second is really firmware, which gives the products the life. It's the core of the product.
It's showing.
It's green right now.
Okay, it's green. Okay, and so as I get closer, it'll get closer to red. We went and just interviewed a bunch of folks that we knew in industry about safety systems, about robotic systems. And they all needed these things, this high resolution, high frame rate, depth sensing, AI, computer vision, and like standalone compute all on a camera. Everyone needed it. And we're just like, man, there's so much like life and limb we can save if we build the platform and enable engineers all over the world to go solve these problems. Babies that are born before term that could be very at risk. Traditionally, before computer vision, that needed to be done by actually gluing sensors. And so that has circulation risk, strangulation risk, and it also doesn't give you all the data that you need. With computer vision, you can actually even get heart rate visually. You can get motion over time. You can get stress either by like viewed by how the baby's moving or facial expressions. All of these things can be real-time quantified, and the robot doesn't have to sleep. Now, one doctor can be monitoring 20 babies in a way as if you'd need 200 doctors to give that level of care. It's not about replacing doctors, it's not about replacing workers, it's about augmenting them and making them more effective at what they do. There's so many cases where roughneck jobs, for example, oil and gas, where it's extremely dangerous. And the only thing that keeps people safe is human perception. And now with robotic perception that can parody human perception in these myopic ways, but it doesn't get bored, it doesn't lose attention, it doesn't get distracted, it doesn't get sleep deprived.
A construction worker has died after a crash on 35 in Dallas. It happened at about 2:30 this morning near Overton Road.
This technology can directly save lives, right? But then looking to like farming, for example, say you're trying to kill pests. Like as the robot goes over, it can literally identify the pests in 3D space and kill them with a laser. And so it's this new wave of efficiency where you can actually do organic farming better than it's ever been done you actually, if we went full organic, you can't feed the planet. You literally just can't. The innovation in non-organic farming is what's enabled us to feed the planet. But you put sprinkle robotics in there, and now you can do something that's actually better than organic farming for the planet, and you can still feed the planet. So just absolutely incredible the impact that it can have on the world.
Making this a better device than what we're trying to build fast.
In any one of these industries, it's this adoption of AI, adoption of perception, adoption of robotics is going to make those companies that much more efficient and safer.
Now, it's on auto face detect.
There's the AI.
Working with camera sensors, high-speed designs, and high-power solutions, the most challenging would be integrating everything on the same board. Also, the cooperation with mechanical engineers so that we make sure that we dissipate heat really efficiently out of the boards so that image sensors are not impacted.
Easy tools that are everywhere is what spurs innovation.
Altium is an excellent fit for us because we are very nimble in design. So we are very fast. We iterate quite fast.
It's when can you actually get to production with the design is the main thing.
Yeah, at first we were collaborating with mechanical engineers in the way that we exchanged export step files. There was one point where we kind of had a big issue with that because at some point, a mechanical engineer was not having the latest design of one board.
Nowadays, because there's so much supply chain disruption, maybe the boards take 6 to 8 weeks to come back. And so when you have an error there, the real cost is burning those 6 to 8 weeks.
Altium 365 can interpret changes graphically. You can just really interactively look through the changes for different revisions. Yeah, it's more definite when you mark something on the actual design than maybe making screenshots.
Because you're using these tools, you're using Altium 365, and as you save those iteration cycles, that enables you to have less risk when you do higher volume initial production. I mean, you're looking at maybe a 80% reduction in time to market. We have now passed the threshold where AI-based computer vision can outperform a human. It really ends up being a force amplifier for human intelligence. It's just now a robot can do most of the mundane things and the backbreaking things, and then it's just that amplification of human intelligence. That's what I've dedicated my life to, is getting powerful tools out to the whole world so this innovation can occur. So my hope is this stuff is gonna end up absolutely everywhere. But no one will know that it's our technology in there, right? Because it's built into some product. It's allowed this to exist. And that's extremely exciting to me. That's what I want to accomplish with my life.
Here's the open. I'm like current, you know, I go where's the less resistance.
Thank you for watching Altium Stories. If you enjoyed what you've seen, please give us a like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think, so please leave a comment in the section below.